I feel like we're coming to a time where everyone at some point is putting out some kind of content out to the world. And I can guarantee that more people are editing video than ever before. And a lot of people are looking for something that's easy to learn and use, but also has all the tools to get professional results. So today we got it. We're gonna take a look at HitFilm by FXHOME. All right, let's take a quick tour around HitFilm so I can show you some of the things it could do. Okay, so I have my timeline here, which is really intuitive. You have your video tracks and your audio tracks right here on the side. To the left, you have different columns like your library tab, things like built-in music, sound effects, and video templates. Next to that, you have your media tab, which is where all your clips and your audio for your project will be. Your effects tab, which we'll take a look at that in a second. Next to that, your history tab, which shows all the changes you made on your timeline. You have your text tab for all your titles. Next to that is controls, which will be where you can make adjustments to your clips on your timeline and controls for the effects that you add to those clips. All right, here in my media tab, I have two clips here of Vanessa. I'll grab one of them and drag it over onto the timeline. And as you can see, this is log footage. This was shot in S-Log 2 on a Sony ZV-E10. Now, normally I would correct and grade my footage at the end of my edit, but I kind of want to bring this clip to life and add some color to it so I could show you guys some of the tools inside of HitFilm. With our clip selected, we can come over here to the effects tab, come down to color grading, and you can see there's a built-in option to apply a custom LUT. And now the controls for that LUT are available in the controls tab, and it automatically pops up. And as you can see here, there's no path, meaning we don't have a LUT selected. So we'll click on the folder, we'll find our custom LUT. I do have an S-Log 2 conversion LUT that I made with Cinematch. We'll click on that, we'll click open, and boom, look at that. If we wanted to make some more changes, maybe to the exposure, we have that option. We can come up to the effects tab, and we have a few different ways we can do it. I personally like to go to color correction. We'll come over and use Exposure Pro. And this tool is pretty self-explanatory. We have our exposure slider, contrast, shadows, midtones, highlights, whites, blacks, vibrance, and saturation. So I think I will pull the midtones up just a little bit and the shadows up just a little bit to brighten up Vanessa. Maybe even turn the contrast up just a hair. Pull the midtones up a little more. Bring down the whites a little bit. And we could turn down the saturation just a touch. I think it's a little too oversaturated. And that looks good. And we could turn our adjustments on and off to see our changes. That was before. This is after. I think it looks pretty good.
HitFilm also has some adjustable presets that you could use here that's built in that you could apply a quick creative look to your clips.
I'll come up here to effects. I'll come down to color grading, and we have things like bleach bypass, cine style, classic cine style, color cycle, a whole bunch of things we could do here. We can go from day to night, but let's come up to cine style. It added a film look, which is definitely a little overdone, but we can dial it back a little bit. And it also gave us the widescreen cinematic letterbox on the top and the bottom. So again, if we come over to controls, we'll see cine style, and then we have our drop down menu right here, and we could dial that S curve back just a little bit because we already added the contrast that we wanted in the Exposure Pro effect before. So we'll dial that S curve back, and we can even dial the color adjustment back too, which is this overall cinematic look that it's given here. So we'll bring it a little bit more closer to what we originally have. We'll drop it down to, like, I don't know, 26%, and that looks good. And we could turn it on and off. There is off, there is on. We have some exposure adjustments that we can make within the cine style effect. We could drop the saturation down. We can come down to our letterbox. We have our offset where we can move our image up and down and have it centered just right within those black bars. So that looks better there. We also have a grain effect here, and we have our vignette effect here that we can make adjustments to.
Tone coloring is another cool effect inside of HitFilm. It lets you target specific areas of your clip to fine tune the colors.
So if you want to change the color of the sky in the background, let's say, we can come over here to our highlight hue, and we could turn the adjustments up a little bit so we could see what we're doing. And then we could shift the hue back and forth so we can give it a more greenish look in the sky, or we could pull it more towards blue and purple. And then we could do the same thing with the midtones. So let's say you want to go for a teal and orange type look. You can adjust your midtones to have more of an orangey reddish look, and then just turn up the intensity a little bit. And look at that, we got a nice little teal and orange look here, and that actually looks really good. We could turn our tone coloring on and off, and that was before.
And that was after, and I like the after. Also up here in the effects tab, we have some scopes that we could check out to monitor our footage. So we have our histogram, a parade, a vector scope, and a waveform. So if we select something like a waveform, you could see it right here. And if we come down here to video cleanup, we also have things like a stabilizer. We can crop and pan, we can de-interlace, we can actually denoise, we can remove grain, motion lock, we could fix roll and shutter, and we could even remove some wires in the background. Now let's come over here to our library tab where we have our music, our sound effects, and our video templates. In our music tab, we can come to hip hop. If we like that song, we can come over here, add it to our media pool, and then we come over to our media tab, and there it is. Our music is sitting there for us to drag it over and use it on our timeline. Same thing applies to sound effects. We can come over to sound effects. We could choose transitions. Say we like this one right here. Click download, add it to media, and there it is in our media tab, and then you could just drag it on over and throw it on your track, and now you could use it. And then we can come over here to our templates, and we have a bunch of stuff to choose from. We'll go with intros and openers for now. And you could actually just hover your mouse over whatever you want to see, and it'll show you a preview of it. We have this modern one right here. We could click add, and again, it's going to add it to our media pool. We could select it, come over to our control tab. We have all different options to make changes to this specific tool.
I'll put my name here, and boom, we have a quick and easy intro.
And if we click play,
there's so many ways to add style onto your clips using HitFilm. It's an impressive editor. The website that you could find HitFilm on is called FXHOME.com. They have a free plan available for everyone, and they also have some great upgrades like their creator plan starting at just $6.25 a month, which gets you a bunch of extra features and software like their pro photo editor, iMerge. Again, I'll leave a link down below for FXHOME so you can try it out for yourself. Thank you, FXHOME, for sponsoring today's video. Thank you guys for watching. Thumbs up, subscribe, all that good stuff. I'll see you guys next time. Yeah!